Hi, Matt Michael here, winemaker for Robert Young Estate Winery, and we are standing right now in our Cabernet Franc hillside vineyard. A lot of times the hillside blocks are carved out to Cabernet Sauvignon. At Robert Young, we did take a couple acres and we planted it to Cabernet Franc. And what makes that special is that the hillside Cabernet, or in general hillside reds, they typically have more structure, more color, more density. And so you get the best offering that you possibly can from your hillside, as a general rule of thumb. And that falls true with our Cabernet Franc here on the hillside. Cabernet Franc is one of the five Noble Bordeaux Reds. So in order of prevalence, it would be Cabernet Sauvignon, then Merlot, then Cabernet Franc, and then Petit Verdot and Malbec. Cabernet Franc is one of the parents of Cabernet Sauvignon, which a lot of people don't realize. A cross between Cabernet Franc and Sauvignon Blanc created Cabernet Sauvignon. So a lot of the characters that you will see in Cabernet Sauvignon as a red come from Cabernet Franc as its parent. So what typically people get in Cabernet Franc is a strawberry plum note that's very varietal. You're going to get a little bit of dried herbs. You may get a little bit of tobacco leaf, maybe wet tobacco leaf, and a little bit of maybe every once in a while a little touch of green bell pepper. That's the variety at its core. It's typically a medium color, can have high color density on hillside sites like this, and a medium tannin, medium body, medium structure. It brings a lot of those savory notes, and as well as a beautiful strawberry and plum note to any of the Bordeaux blends. So you don't typically see Cabernet Franc blended in large proportions into a Bordeaux blend. That little 1-5% ratio really kind of makes up a great amount in the overall blend in terms of what it offers and what it contributes to the final project. So here on this wine, we have 100% Cabernet Franc. It's hillside. And I think when I smell this, it's just screams varietal. I mean, you get tons of plum, tons of strawberry, nice dried herb note through there, a little bit of wet tobacco leaf. And you see the color is a nice medium to dark ruby color. And I had a sip of this earlier. Nice structure, nice body. And it's right where it should be. A varietal Cabernet Franc from this area. Beautiful. Some of the things that you compare this with off the grill or out of your kitchen would be, think pork, think grilled pork, think of maybe trout with crispy skin, think of a little bit of maybe braised chicken with the skins on, or barbecued after with the skins on, any sort of kind of middle of the road cheese. So I would think maybe a lighter Roquefort, things of that nature that have some texture to it, but not a lot, would be perfect for this wine. So we hope you enjoy it. Let us know.